All right, I'm going to take about 5 minutes of time to talk to you about one of the most commonly used buzzwords that are misunderstood in education today. Most of us believe we understand it, but what the world represents is so complex it's often difficult to define. If you haven't guessed, the buzzword is engagement. When it comes to student engagement, there are many types, but unfortunately there are no clear answers as to what actually inspires our students to be engaged or how we can improve those different types of learning. What I can tell you is that student engagement does not look like this. I didn't realize that back on Tuesday, September 5th, 2006, when I began the long journey to start rewarding my students for 89 straight weeks that semester. It took me less than 2 weeks before everybody in my class wanted out, and that was including me. I didn't think I was going to be in this profession very long. I may not have been able to define what engagement looked like at the time, but I knew that that was not it. With the daily reading on the engagement scale at the level 0 on a daily basis, I checked my familiarity to technology for some help. This allowed me to spend more time focusing on classroom management rather than writing a note on the board. But the math class itself was still a drag. I believe that if I could better manage my room, students would be engaged in my lesson. If I could get them to do what they're supposed to do, then everything would be better. Now, although the technology did improve the behavioral engagement of my students, it did little to nothing to engage them intellectually. Unfortunately, the vanity metric I was using to measure engagement was that behavioral improvement. And when I was using those boring slideshows that I now refer to them as, I believe the technology was the magic pill to solve all my problems. Now, this blinded view had quickly put me on a path to implement the next tech tool in my classroom. I was completely ignorant to all the interesting parts of mathematics, likely because they had never been shown to me before myself. So in came the smart boards, the clickers, the laptop cards, iPads, and Apple TVs in order to supposedly engage my students. I wasn't the only one tricked. I got the label of good teacher simply because that guy uses technology. By this point, I was observing improvements in success rates and believed technology was a key factor. I had seemingly found a working formula for standardized tests, but were my students actually engaged with the math? And were they enjoying the process, or were they just compliant? It wasn't in 2012 when I attended an OAMA session that completely changed my approach to teaching. My eyes were open, and I knew ideas I never knew existed, and I started building on them for my students to better engage and enjoy the process of learning. Before long, I was in the math Twitter bio student blogosphere, as many of you would know it. Now I'm part of a global professional learning community consisting of hundreds of math teachers from all over the world to stretch my thinking. Now, while I still believe that innovative uses of technology can increase intellectual engagement, my blinders have been lifted to see that focusing on one small piece of the puzzle is merely a band-aid solution that's sure to hide the underlying problems. Realizing that the traditional lesson format I'd always been using was student familiarity rather than effectiveness or efficiency, I knew that I had to make a change. I was tired of being the gatekeeper of knowledge and wanted my students to have a role in that learning process. Trying to teach math by giving students all the answers, a list of definitions, and eight examples is like giving someone a crossword puzzle with all the solutions written on the page. We've sucked at any opportunity for curiosity or thinking. Now, I don't believe anyone in the room would argue that algorithms alone would lead students to be engaged in our math classrooms, and we would likely agree that successfully using a formula will definitely not mean that students understand math. So, unfortunately, it took me 8 years to realize that the traditional math lesson that you see up here that was based on steps and procedures or inquiry was promoting students to memorize the math in my class rather than build a deep understanding of how well. Now, lessons are delivered in a task-based format, allowing students to use the inquiry process on a daily basis to make connections to their prior knowledge. When students prove to themselves that they can solve a problem independent of the steps, we can extend thinking to a new learning goal with greater ease. Now, what I've realized only recently is that maximizing intellectual engagement of my students has less to do with math tasks, making them real or relevant, but rather how we ask those questions. So if I've learned anything about engagement, it's to never stop trying to find new ways to leverage that natural curiosity that we all have in order to expose the beauty of mathematics to our students. And I truly believe if we can find a way to do that daily, then student engagement will be a buzzword.